If Kentucky Senator, former presidential candidate Rand Paul is intimidated by the strong-arming that's been coming from the White House these days to try to get this health care thing sealed, done, and out of there, he has a funny way of showing it. While he has met with the president, hopes to find a solution to try to get past this impasse, he has already indicated, that is Senator Rand Paul, that as far as this latest deal is concerned, he's a no vote, and furthermore, against even a procedural vote on it scheduled for early next week. He joins us right now on the phone. Senator, good to have you.
Thanks, Neil.
Are you worried that's going to get the president very angry?
You know, I spoke with the president yesterday, and I think he's very interested in what conservatives want. I think he considers himself to be from the conservative wing of the party, and I think he truly wants what most of us want, which is repeal of Obamacare. And I think if it doesn't happen, if the Senate leadership can't put it together, my hope is that he steps into the fray and helps push us along. He's indicated that he's open to my idea, which is separate it into a clean repeal like we promised the voters. And then if there are spending projects that moderates want that weren't part of the promise to repeal, put them on a bill they can work with Democrats on. There are many must-pass bills or supposedly must-pass bills that will come up. And the Democrats and the big government Republicans could work on the spending plans, and the rest of us, including the moderates, could vote on a clean repeal.
Don't you think we're kind of past that, though, now, Senator? I'm just beginning to wonder whether there's a new sentiment building, and maybe this is where the president's coming from. Anything is better than the law we have, and something is better than nothing, and it leads the way to tax reform. So get out of the way, Rand Paul. Come along.
No, I think we haven't gotten to my solution yet. The other solution has to fail to get to my solution. And the reason I'm against the current bill is I think it's Obamacare light. I think it doesn't fix the fundamental flaw of Obamacare. The fundamental flaw is that if you make insurance expensive to buy through regulations, but then tell people they can buy it after they get sick, leads to the death spiral we have in Obamacare. The Republican plan doesn't fix that. In fact, the Republican plan acknowledges the death spiral of Obamacare will continue. They're going to subsidize it with this massive insurance bailout super fund. That is simply a bailout of the death spiral of Obamacare and an acknowledgement that they're not going to fix the death spiral.
So what happens in the interim? Why wouldn't you want to encourage this debate? Because you're very, very good at, you know, getting through all of these key points. But if you don't even allow a procedural vote, I mean, people will interpret that as you're being obstinate. You're fighting with the wishes of the Senate majority leader.
No, I'm fighting for what I promised. Yeah, I'm fighting for what I promised the voters and all 52 Republicans promised.
But a procedural vote isn't the same thing, right, Senator? As saying you're going to buy the whole thing, hook, line, and sinker, right?
But if you watch the Senate closely, the way it works is once you get on the bill, it will be rammed down our throats. No amendments will pass. They're going to say, oh, we have an open amendment process. But everyone in leadership and all the Democrats will oppose the good amendment. So no amendments will pass. And realize that we're going to go through 100, 200 amendments at the very end. Leadership's going to do what they call a wraparound amendment.
Right.
And they're going to cancel out all amendments. Let's say I passed 10 amendments that were
so
good.
You're not budging, even if it means it's going to alienate you with the, you know, Mitch McConnell and maybe with the President of the United States.
No, I keep proposing new solutions. And the new solution that I think will work for everybody is split the bill in two, have a clean repeal like we promised, and then if the big government Republicans want spending programs, they want bailouts for the insurance industry, they can do that with the Democrats.
Okay, real quickly, Senator Tim Scott was telling me earlier today that he would be open and wanted to remind conservatives, maybe by extension folks like you, Senator, that if you're worried about keeping those taxes in Obamacare, don't worry because they can come out in a tax reform measure and effort later on. I think that's the gist of it. What do you make of that?
I guess my problem with that suggestion is any time in Washington they tell you you're going to do it at a later date, it means they're really not going to do it. The most common thing on the floor when you bring something up they don't like is, well, Senator, we really love your idea. It's a jolly well good idea, but you're just not bringing it up at the right time. If you will wait your turn until you're older and wiser, we will listen to your committee in 10 or 15 years, and then maybe we'll bring your issue to the floor. Now, it's always a promise. It's a false promise. If they don't have the guts to repeal the Obamacare taxes now, they'll never have the guts. And it's disappointing. Look, this is what we ran on for four elections. Republicans ran four times, and won every time on repeal Obamacare, and now they're going to vote to keep it. Disappointing.
All right. Senator, we'll watch very closely. Thanks for taking the time.
Thanks, Neil.
All right. In the meantime, JP.